people like to believe in fairy tales. Camelot. It's been reprinted all over the world. Maybe that's what they'll all believe now.
The film covers primarily the days after the assassination.
They were just in Dallas on this sunny, beautiful day. Then all of a sudden, it's over. And in those 4 or 5 days, she had to make important decisions and somehow just putting the entire pain of a country over her back.
I will not sneak out the back door. I will go out the usual way. We all will.
You get to revisit something that you think you really, really know. You're like, I didn't know that at all. I didn't even have any idea.
Mommy, where's Daddy?
Daddy had to go see a baby brother, Patrick, in heaven.
Jackie had to pretend to be so many different things at different times.
I know you think I'm some silly little debutante.
You're seeing the private moment after the cameras were turned off. These icons that people look up to are actually human.
Jackie was a trailblazer and was able to reach the American people and knew how to do it and knew how to connect with them.
Do you know who James Garfield was?
No, ma'am.
Do you know who William McKinley was, what he did? They were both U.S. presidents killed while they were in office.
I never thought that she got the credit that she deserved for being a genius of image creation and myth-making in crafting the mythology of Camelot.
I must get this right. A big, beautiful procession people will remember.
When you want to tell the story of somebody's life, what you do under a crisis will define you more than what you do every day.
Those pictures should record the truth. Two heartbroken, fatherless children are part of that.
We're getting to look and feel for Jackie, not as an icon, not as a symbol, but as a person.
Oh, that keeps running through my mind. Don't let it be forgot. That for one brief, shining moment, there was a Camelot.